Paul Rodriguez, Recon Athlete, on the phone right now. Paul, thank you for joining us as always, family.
Hey, my pleasure, man. How are y'all feeling tonight?
Feeling wonderful, wonderful. So I guess, is the kicker from the Austin area going to Texas the biggest recruiting news this week when you talk about Will Stone from Regents verbally committing to head to the 40 acres?
Yeah, you have to admit, that I think that is the biggest news of the week so far. But for Will Stone to kind of get that commitment and follow in, you know, to the long legacy that we have for Austin kickers, Justin Tucker, the most recent notable name. And, you know, I know Dicker's out there also, you know, roaming around, going to land on a team soon in the NFL. But I'm looking forward to seeing how, you know, he's going to make that transition to the 40 acres. But that's the most exciting news. And that edit, though, whoever put that edit together at Texas, that was a dope edit for him.
Paul, okay, so like I said, most of the offers, there's just a lot of camps going on really right now. I wanted to ask you about a situation that we heard allegedly that Arizona State was having kids on campus during the NCAA dead period, and your thoughts on that.
Yeah, it's all a lot of, you know, hearsay right now, rumors. I think if we do see a big, I don't want to say punishment, but if we do see some kind of adverse action taken by the NCAA, then we'll have to really believe that that really was occurring. I'm going to give the benefit of the doubt so far right now to Coach Herm Edwards. He's never struck me as a guy who is going to bend the rules that far. So I'm just going to reserve my you know, judgment on his part right now. But like I said, if we do see the NCAA come down and lay down any kind of sanctions or any kind of punishment to Arizona State, we'll have to really believe that that was occurring. But listen, man, this is college football. This is going to happen. There's so much competition. There's literally billions of dollars on the lines for these universities, and they're trying to figure out a way, you know, to walk on the other edge of the rule book. I'm just going to put it right there. They're walking on the line, well, but it's on the other side. It's on the other edge.
You know, Paul, you play to win the game.
That's right.
You play to win the game. Now, Paul, I know, like, we talked about it briefly, was how a program like Liberty Hill was going to get more recognition as far as recruiting from a D1 school, Lloyd Johnson. And we see the Recon Athlete edit with the Houston Baptist offer. And then the second part of my question, and really should just be two different questions, but is Austin Novosad, where do you rank him amongst Austin area underclassmen who haven't yet verbally committed to a school?
That's a great two-part question. Let's stick with Lloyd on the first part with Liberty Hill.
Okay.
He also landed an offer from the FCS national champion Sam Houston State Bearcats. You know, so go ahead. He got that offer as well. And I think more offers like that and having the – and there's big kids out there. That's what people, I think, get a little bit confused when they run the slot T, is that, oh, it's a bunch of shorter, you know, more stocky kids who don't have the speed. And that's completely untrue with what the athletes they have out there. But, yeah, Lloyd Johnson, I think he may even go D1 mid-major. So I wouldn't be surprised if, you know, we start seeing, like, Louisiana's go in, trying to get him, Texas State's. And then transitioning and pivoting to Austin Novosad. Snoop, I went back and I watched his – when he got that offer from Baylor, I was like, there's something here that I think a lot of people are missing. We saw what he did last year in Dripping Springs when he had his, you know, prolific receivers there with Alford and with O'Bannon. He's going to have even more targets, I think, coming up to this year as his junior year. But I went back and I watched his huddle, and I said, let me watch it again. Let me watch it again. And I watched it four times, and I had to go back, and I said, let me look at pro-style throwing motions. And his comp, in my opinion, this is a humble opinion with a small mic, his comp is Peyton Manning. The way he's getting the ball out, and it's such a quick release, I think that he has a huge upside. We went ahead and just gave him a 4 stars. He is in the mix with the top quarterbacks in the Austin area, with Cade Klubnik, with Bo Edmondson. He's going to be right up there, and there is something special, I think, brewing in Dripping Springs, especially with them being in division or a classification 5A D1. They may be very special. They may be replacing Cedar Park as the top school with Coach Abseck leaving to Barbara Hills.
Yeah, Coach Galen Zimmerman is definitely working something special. And Paul, we even talk about drip outside of football. Mm-hmm. You talk about the girls' soccer team winning the state championship. You talk about the baseball team going into the game just before the state Final Four, losing in the 14th inning to Rouse on a crazy walk-off. Dripping Springs as a whole is on the rise. Yep. And I think Austin Novosad, I want to say he's almost come out of nowhere to become elite. And it's really exciting to watch. And he's just coming out of his sophomore year going into junior season.
Most definitely. I know his brother's on the squad as well, I believe, as a receiver. And I think that's what a lot of time we're going to see these. You get to see the preview, Snoop. You're so lucky with your baseball coverage. You get to see these athletes when they're competing in the spring and then they transition to sevens and into the fall. I have high hopes for that school out there in Dripping Springs, but yeah, it's going to be a fun time. And you know, so many new things going on as far as the coaching ranks here and locally in the Austin area. It's a fun time right now. I think we're going to have a lot more big name coaches like we just had with the 6A classifications, with John Walsh coming into San Marcos, Bobby Acosta to drip to Del Valle. And then now that we have, you know, such big names coming into Austin, I think we are going to have a fun time as we move forward with our coverage as people who are doing it.
Yeah. And just a couple of guys that Novosad will be throwing to besides Preston Alford, who's had several Division I offers, but Garen Duncan, who's also a class of 23, as well as Noah Lawyer, the big receiver on the outside. So, Paul, great stuff as always. Appreciate you coming on at 8:20 or any time that we can get you on a Thursday night. We're super appreciative. Before we let you go, are you shouting out to anybody tonight?
Oh, man, let's just shout out to all the young people out there sacrificing and grinding. It's camp season. It's, you know, it's time for everybody to go out there and show it off and get those highlights out. But I want to just give a special shout out to, you know, Papa Romeo and my family out here who are, you know, enjoying the time and enjoying your program. Snoop, we've been talking about this for a long time, and it's pretty cool to kind of see where FLXATX is now, where Recon Athlete is now. It's fun, and I just want to thank you and Zach and Nolan and your team, Derek, for you know, letting us be a part of you on Thursday nights.
Hey, that's what's up. Papa Romeo, shout out to you. Paul Rodriguez, Recon Athlete. We'll talk to you next week. Thank you, family.
Thanks, sir.